Hi everyone, it's Dutch River here and welcome to the latest Focus Friday video. Today I'm going to tell you a little more about keeping soft corals, which are also referred to as leather corals, because they have a leathery skin, most of them, and well, they are pretty easy to keep corals, so if you're new to this hobby, I can definitely recommend that you check out this video and see, take a look at some of the soft leather corals that are in my tank. Hopefully they can provide some inspiration for your tank. And even as an advanced aquarist, it's also nice to keep soft corals, especially to have some variation in your tank between all the SPS and LPS. It's always nice to have some soft corals in there to spice things up a bit. It's pretty dark in the room here. It's because it's very it has been very hot for the past few days. It's over 35 degrees now, so outside. So in the house it's about 28-29 degrees, so the cooler is doing its job very well, and the water is keeping stable at around 25 degrees, so happy with that. So that's why, that explains why it's a bit dark here. So, but at least the tank is lighted, so you can take a good look at that. So I'll give you a quick look around the various soft corals that I have in my tank. I'll take you through their names as well. At least for most of them I have the Latin names, so you can look them up. I'll also provide the names in the description, so you can search them up for yourself if you want to. And yeah, well, let's start. Well, I was actually surprised that, because I thought I only had three or four soft corals, but then when I started looking, I found out that I had quite a lot more. Actually, I have about seven of them in my tank. So let's take a look. The first one, and I think it's also the most beautiful one, is right here. It's bright green. It's called a Cinularia dura. And they come in various colors, and I think this is the most beautiful color that you can get. I think it's especially very green now because it's shedding its skin. So as you can probably see, the it's a bit the polyps are retracted, so the polyps are not extending at the moment. That's because its skin is shedding, and I'm assuming it will take a day or two until the skin comes off. But like I said, it's a very beautiful color. You also have them in brown, but I think, of course, green is a lot more beautiful, especially considering the fluorescence. Then on the back, you might have seen that before, is a green star polyp, which is also a type of soft coral, and it's very easy to keep. It looks like grass, and it's very nice to keep on, like, for example, your background. The background of your tank, because it gives a nice wavy look to your tank, and it has the room to grow to the left and to the right. And if it gets too big, then you can easily take a knife and cut off a piece, use a scraper to get it off the back of the tank. Then directly in front of that you'll see a Gorgonian, which is also a soft coral. This one is a purple feather Gorgonian, or a purple brush Gorgonian as it's more often referred to. It's the base is purple and the polyps are somewhat more brownish, and this coral also completely depends on light, so it doesn't need any targeted feeding. As long as there's enough light and enough flow, then it will do very well, and it will be happy in your tank. I've had this one for about a year now, and it's growing steadily, not very fast, but it's growing. Then a soft coral that you might be a little confused about is this organ pipe coral, which is also known as Tubipora musica. It has a it can be mistaken with an SPS coral, because the base is actually quite stony, but then again the flowers that come out of it are definitely soft corals, so these are a member of the soft coral family. Same goes for these, which is also an organ pipe coral. Looks a little less more beautiful, a little less beautiful. But then again, this one is really, really doing well. Also, for about, I think, 1.5, 2 years now, at least 1.5 years, and it's growing steadily. It's also grown all the way to the back, so it's has grown quite in size. I'm not sure if you can see it from here. Yeah, you can see it as well, a little less clear, but it's a really nice coral with also a very nice mint green appearance. Also here you can see the purple feather gorgonian a bit better, purple brush gorgonian, and also yeah, I really like this one. Very beautiful purple color. It's not fluorescent, but definitely under daylight you will enjoy it. And a little bit more to the right, the latest addition to my tank is this devil's hand coral, and the Latin name is Lobophytum. And yeah, as you can see, it's quite bright in color. I've had placed it high in the tank because I've been told that if you put it a bit high in the tank, then the color will get more beautiful and more beautiful. So I think it's already very beautiful. Also because the polyps, there are really small white flowers coming out of the coral, and that gives the coral a nice overall fluffy look. And I must say, I'm really happy that I decided to buy this one. It does really well in my tank. And it, like I said, leather corals are easy to keep, so yeah, you can keep them as well. And even if you're if you just started out, your tank is just running for a few months, you can definitely add one of these to your tank. Same goes for all the soft corals that I'm showing you. Another Tubipora musica is right here. So the one I showed you before, which I had two, this is the third one. It's also yeah, it's also looking like a nice green field of flowers. Then by far the largest coral in my tank is also a soft coral. That's this one. This one is actually called a Sacrophyton, or a Sarcophyton. I'm not sure how you pronounce it, but I'll try my best. And in the Netherlands we refer to this as a toadstool, because it, yeah, you can see it looks a bit like a toadstool, especially when you consider the shape. The base of the coral is also pretty thin, and then it expands into this huge cap, so that's why it's called a toadstool. So this one was even bigger before. I have decided to frag it. As you can see right here, the front is still intact. On the back, I cut off three pieces, so to the left, in the middle, and to the right. You can see it better from the side, by the way. I just took a knife, or actually scissors, and just cut off a piece of it, or actually three pieces, and it's healing up very nicely. As you can see right here, small new polyps have already started to appear after about a month, and it's yeah, it's really recovering just fine. And then the last soft coral in my tank is this one. Like the first one I showed you, this is also a Cinularia, but not a Cinularia dura, but a Cinularia flexibilis. The difference, main difference is that it it's not very flat, but it has hands that are extending, and then the polyps come out of the hands that are extending. So to show you a little bit better, and this one is also quite easy to keep. It's not as fluorescent as the first one, but then again, still it has a nice green, yeah, a nice green look to it. So it's definitely not as brown as some of these corals are. So yeah, that's a quick overview of the soft leather corals that I have in my tank. As you can see, most of them are actually pretty colored. That's I think the challenge when you're looking for soft corals. Always keep an eye out for the beautiful ones. The most beautiful colored ones come from Fiji, so if you ask your LFS for a Fiji soft coral, then they probably know what you're talking about, and then they can maybe look for you to get one. And yeah, so that's about it. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope you are convinced that soft corals can be a very nice addition to the reef tank. And I'll see you in the next video. So bye bye, have a nice weekend.